Now, Ray and I are about to play a fun new game. It's time for Explain This Photo. Hmm. Here we go.
Explain this photo.
So, basically, before the show, I don't know why we agreed to do this, but we swapped cell phones and we looked through each other's photo albums. And I found some pictures on your phone, and I think you found some photos on my phone.
I did.
And they need some explaining.
They're a little confusing look at them. Yeah.
All right, very good. Now I've got your phone here, and here this is my phone here. But this is the first.
I may have to put glasses on. Is that going to ruin the bit if I put glasses on?
No, you can put glasses on. You can do whatever you want. But I can just show it to you. Here, I can describe what's on here. Here's a photo. This is. What? Can we get a close up of?
This is a great moment in my life, actually. This is a great moment.
Yeah. Now what is the? Are you? That's Kenny G. Am I wrong?
That's Kenny G. I don't know if there are any golfers in the audience, but that's Phil Mickelson. And he had just won. He had just won the British Open. This is at Pebble Beach, where I play in the Pro-Am.
Yeah.
And you get the claret jug. You get to carry. It's like the Stanley Cup.
Oh my gosh! Yeah.
So we all had to drink some wine out of the claret jug. And I got to be honest, it was a stressful moment because I don't drink, and I'm a germaphobe, you know.
Oh my God.
But I have a man crush on Phil Mickelson.
And Kenny G.
Well, Kenny G is there to calm me down. You know what I mean?
Yes. To get out of control.
Yes.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I don't drink not because of Kenny G, but no. Well, actually, no. He's related to the last time I drank. I got really drunk, and I went to the bathroom, and I started hearing Kenny G in the bathroom, and I realized I'm pissing in the elevator.
That's when you know you gotta stop. That's when you know you gotta stop.
By the way, I love Kenny G, and he's a good friend of mine, and I love his music.
Me too. All right. So,
speaking of music, I found this.
Okay. Yeah, I can explain this.
This needs a little explanation.
All right. Look. So all right. So I spent. First of all,
is that a cake?
It's not a cake. This is a turntable. It's a picture disc.
It's an actual.
Here's the truth. If this were 20 years ago, where you had to use film and a camera, this photo wouldn't exist. But there's the fact that I can take 1,000 photos on my cell phone and not really worry about it. That's why this photo exists. I have a record, a vinyl listening room in my house that I listened to, and I got this record from my uncle, and I was. It's a picture disc of Barry Manilow's greatest hits.
Barry Manilow, too.
I didn't know how many hits. It's unbelievable. I was listening to Daybreak. And it was like, it's a daybreak. Daybreak. Yeah. So I was listening to that song. And I haven't heard that in a long time. I go, that's a fantastic song. And then I just got entranced by his spinning head. And I just had to take a picture of Barry. So Barry, I know you are watching. If you have any more picture discs, send them over. I would love to play them. They're very fantastic.
And Kenny G, too.
And Kenny G, if you have a picture disc as well. All right. Explain this photo. What happened here?
The only way I can explain that is, put it this way, when your wife is making pancakes, never say, where's mine, fatso?
That's not true.
No, my wife is, by the way.
What
this is vinyl. This is vinyl related. This is a cool thing about the show. I don't know what the next episode is, and they just told me I had to get a prosthetic nose made, and I get beat up, and they break my nose. And I don't know if you know, they had to do my nose in sections.
There wasn't enough plaster to cover their whole nose at once.
They had to cover their plaster.
Okay, here we go.
This one I like, too. Yeah, this one I tried to figure out.
So I was sent this from my writer, one of our writers, my best friend, sent me, this is mid-fist right there. Here's what happened. That's my bathroom, my dressing room. It's a true story. It was my birthday, and my writer friend was hiding in my bathroom with the lights off for about 20 minutes with a clown mask, an army jacket, and a real knife. And he was videotaping so I walked in, I turned the lights on, and I went to punch the clown. And,
That's your friend.
That's my buddy. He's my best friend. Yeah. Gerard.
I guess, you know what, a clown with a knife is scary, but probably more scary, a clown with a plunger, because then you don't know what just happened.
What? You don't even want to get involved with what just happened. Here's the last one here, and this one,
this is...
It's just odd. I mean, explain this to me, because I... Look at your muscle there.
Yeah.
But look how big your muscle is there. Can you see, like...
And yeah, that's... Part of that is my wife's head, not my muscle.
I recognize your wife's head, but yeah, but then...
Here's the weird part is I can't take credit for that muscle, because it looks like I got a gun there.
Yeah.
And it's not. It's a... What happened was I broke the tendon in my bicep, ripped... it ripped gradually. Like, it tore, and then it kept tearing a little more. And after, like, one day, the muscle just falls, and you get what's called Popeye muscle. They actually have a condition called Popeye muscle, where you flex it, pops up, and it looks like you're strong.
You can do that?
I have it. I don't know if you can see it through the jacket, through the cool leather.
Can you take the jacket off?
You want to see the Popeye? Why would I do this? Why would I show my deformity on national television? I have a... No.
Oh, my goodness.
This is
episode 6 of Vinyl. It's getting there.
By the way, it's not pretty. I don't know why I'm showing this. Why would I...
Let's see this. We can recreate the photo.
I have a knife scar on my ass. Do you want to see that?
No, save that for next time. Save that for next time.
So what you do is... This is just it, and then when you pop it, it comes out.
All right, I'm gonna get my head in there.
Oh, you want to?
Yeah.